and we will do this thing. I'd say we'll have some fun. I don't know if it's fun. It's probably not exactly how you describe it, but it's a thing. It's fun when you don't have any noise, I'll tell you that much. Yes. Okay, so we're just going to wait. Let's just hang a few minutes and, you know, let's see if everyone can kind of catch up. Is that what? Is that doing something weird? Are we good? We good? We good? Let's just put on. How good are the Black Crows? Let me throw that out there. Damn, they're one of the best. Looks like it's doing something a little whack there. I'm just going to put some music on for a second and make sure that this is doing the right thing. If it is. I see myself there. It's looks like it's behaving. Spring into action, Chris. Excellent. It's a start. It means it's working. You can hear me okay. Yeah. Gives a thumbs up or a hey, all good if it's working the way it's supposed to. I want to try and get a few eyes on here whilst I do this, because otherwise it's not the sort of thing I can go, let me just do that again for you, because that would be, it's going to be a bit of a pain in the butt. Other than that, how is everyone out there? Is anyone okay? As we like to say. I feel like grabbing a guitar and just having a play in the meantime. I don't really have anything set up for that, do I? I've got the implements of soldering and such electronics apparati. And I'm as far from being an electronics. Look, I'm just capable enough. No, just enough to get into trouble and do some damage. But a lot of people do enjoy just tinkering away. I'm one of those people, always changing, not so much anymore, but was always changing pickups and trying different things and learning what I can about the basics of how to get around and do things. Have I learned the basics? Yeah, probably just the basics, but enough. Before I turn the soldering iron on, I just want to show you guys, or I should say let you hear, kind of regular single coil guitar noise. And when I turn the soldering iron on, it's kind of a reasonably beefy one. It introduces this lots of other noise. So we don't want that. Good of you to join me on a public holiday, but I mean, what else are you doing? Enjoying it though, I hope, for those who normally work. Every single time, single coil land is just where I am extremely happy to be. Now, I'm using a plug-in here. I'm just using the Friedman DS40 UAD plugin. Oh, snuck in a nice one there. Okay, so this is basically my favorite type of configuration in strat type guitars, HSS, because if you've only got one instrument to do the job, for me this is the one that gets it done the best. And that is cool, except the humbucker of course has basically no noise, other than the fact that it is a big beefy machine. It obviously creates some noise because of that, but not really hum. I'll crank this up just so you guys get the full, well, as much as possible of the noise factor that I'm talking about. So there's always, inherently, depending on where you are and what your lighting is and stuff, you can always make noise happen. And near the computer, that adds a whole other thing. Sometimes the screens, speakers, they all make noise. Ideally, the only way you're going to get the least amount of noise is out in a field somewhere. Okay, so that's the humbucker. Some noise, but not too bad. Ooh, she's sensitive. Now, when you get under the single coil, that's the problem. So humbucker seems really quiet. Single coil is that. Other single coil is that. In between, a very beautiful place. So the idea of this Ulbrick NRS noise reduction systems is to alleviate that single coil noise. It's funny, I can be over here somewhere. For some reason, there's all this other noise happening, but the hum is not so bad here. But anyway, you don't have to do that. It's always a weird thing. You're at gigs and you're trying to find a spot, or even in the studio, trying to find this ultimate spot where it's quietest, and that's a pain. So yeah, we're trying to alleviate that. And these, this little system here, where is the little device? It's this guy right there. That's what it is. That's what it looks like. By installing these, you get rid of like 95% of that noise, and it doesn't change your tone. That's the whole major thing about it. There's very little to do as far as installing it. It doesn't change the sound of your guitar, because you know, that's what it's all about. I'm just going to say hello because, Craig, how you doing, man? I got to, look, I probably say this all the time, I'm going to aim at streaming a bit more because I miss seeing you guys and having a chat with you. Okay, so let's unplug this guy. So, on the surgical bed here, we have this guy. Now, I've noticed too, when a guitar's out, when you've taken all strings off, and I've even noticed, depending on whether a guitar is horizontal or vertical, you get a big difference in noise and stuff like that too. So anyways, this is what we're going to put the NRS into. HSS. And I want you guys just to be able to see, what I'm doing here. That's nice and clean. Not much going on in there. All right. So let me see if I can demonstrate the noise happening just on this one as an example as well. Got to remember to hold the various earth points. Normally when this is all, obviously guitar's all together, the strings are all on, you've got the earth that goes to the back of the trem. And in this case, you can see, no, you can't, if I go here, there's a little earth connection there. So once it's all together, your hands on the bridge and all that, you get the least amount of noise. It gets rid of those other little electrical kind of noises. So that can be a little more tricky to do this way, but we'll still get an idea, I think. What's, is that even on? Oh, okay. All right. So, because this is on the humbucker, for example. So it's, depending on where it is, still a bit noisy. I've got to make sure I'm doing that. Okay. So that's the humbucker. And I know if I move this down there to a slightly different spot, it'll be a bit less noisy. Single coil. That one in particular, for some reason, the neck is very noisy. So there you've still got noise, as I said, just because of where I am at the moment. So that is, you know, the quietest. Let me just see if it's different if I was to move. Yeah, okay. All right, so if we kind of use that as a benchmark, as in that's what would normally be pretty damn silent. It's the big low hum. That's what we want to get rid of. That one. And I'd say that I need a new volume pot pretty badly. Okay, it's always something in there. Always something. I'll turn the volume down. Okay. Let's do this thing. Because I'm no genius at it, I better start. Otherwise, we could be here for an awfully long time. No, I wouldn't think so. Okay, I'm going to turn the soldering iron on now because, as I said, it induces this other large humming sound. So that's on now. And I've also got the little diagram up here I can show you. It is nice and simple. I was going to say, where is it? It's so small. So this particular model here is what you would put in a standard Strat with three single coils where the middle is a reverse wound. And a HSS is basically the same thing, except you don't have to worry about the humbucker, but you've still got reverse wound middle and neck. So it's kind of like having two of these devices they've managed to roll into the one, so they're going to kind of cancel out the two different directions. That's, I'm not going to get any more technical than that because clearly I don't know the inner workings, nor do I want to know, except that it works. Okay, so all I have to do is, now I've already done one little bit here. Let me just put the other camera on, see if I can get the get this right there. So there's four wires that come off this little loop. Two of them just get soldered together. It's exactly the same colors as when you do your humbucker usually. So the red and the white simply get. And the five-way switch and change things around like that. Not that that's crazy hard, but I don't want to do that. I don't want to be doing that inside the guitar. Just, you know, if I'm going to change anything, I just want it to be very, very minimal as far as changing the pickup tone goes. So this I like because it just seems like, well, there's hardly anything going on. It's not going to change the sound except for get rid of the noise. Okay, so all I've done just before, when I had a look at the diagram and realized that all I've done so far is I've just joined the red and white together. That's all I've done. Okay, so at the moment, I've got, and I've tried to make this, you know, relatively easy to be able to just get this done. So we can see these two. These are the earths coming from the two single coils. Usually they'd be going maybe to the volume pot, or back of the volume pot, back of the tone pot. They're all the same because they're all connected up. So what you would do is remove those. If you had three single coils, then these would all be connected together and on the back of the volume pot. So you just unsolder one thing and all of those earth wires would come off nice and easy. So let's just get these off here. I tried to make this before so that it would be not too difficult. Now, I could be wrong, but I get the feeling that for, let's say, amateur soldering peoples like myself, it's the earths to the back of the volume pots or the back of the pots. It's like our Achilles heel. That's what I think anyway. Got a bit of soldering iron now though, so that helps a lot. Okay, so that's my two earth wires. Whoa! I'll get that. That have come off the two single coils. So if there was a single coil here, that would also be part of this. It'd be three together and you do the same thing. You take them all off. Yes, let me just go grab that little guy. Lucky it's very soft and flexible. That doesn't mean that you should throw it around. Okay, so these two are simply going to go to these black and blue wires. Now, let me just see here again which ones they suggested. So the neck, let's just look at that again. You can see that again. All right, so this is the earth from the neck pickup. This is the plain black wire coming from the NRS. Now, because I'm just doing this sort of a little roughly or quickly, I'm not worrying too much about, you know, getting this into the cavity later and so forth. I mean, it's straightforward anyway, but I'm just going to kind of truck through this so I'm not at it with you guys for too long. But mainly, that's going to kind of just go into there. It's flexible. It's just going into the cavity later. So you might as well have these wires towards this part of the guitar and facing upwards for now anyway. All right, so let's just do this as a bit of a, let's say temporary, but a little bit temporary. Because me doing something that is not temporary, well, that is going to take longer if you want a good soldering job. When it comes to serious things, look, I normally have a go at them and then I handball them onto people who I really trust. Okay, so that's that one done. We then have the other earth wire is going to connect to, let's just look at that diagram. So what I like about this, it is easy. Yep. My GoPro's just gone and carked it, has it? Let me just flick to my GoPro for 1 second to see. Oh no, it's still with us. Good work. Good work, GoPro. And by the way, sorry, in case you are commenting or anything, I can't see that at the moment, but I will have a look there in a second in case there's any questions. But I think I'll just better concentrate on this for a moment. I'm just going to put a tiny bit on there because this is not how I want it to stay. Ideally, once this is done and you're all happy with it, you would then put some heat shrink over these so that obviously when it goes back into the cavity, nothing can be touching anything that it's not supposed to. It sounded a bit strange. Okay, so there we have those two. And then all you do is, in this case, the red and the white, which I've already just joined together like so, they simply go to wherever you disconnected the earth from in the first place. So most commonly, it's going to be the back of the volume pot. So how about I be a good little boy and I practice my back of the volume pot soldering. Now I think the vibe is this. Get a little bit on there and just make sure you've actually got it looking decent like that. I think that's okay. And then this is where you need that other hand, because you should always apply fresh solder whenever you're doing any little joint. This one's not too bad actually. Now that is a little bit ugly, if that's what you were thinking, geez, it's a little ugly you've done there. But the main thing is it's nice and shiny. That's that guy right there. So it means it's heated up enough and the join should be good. It's actually easier, I think, to start a new spot often than, you know, you want ugly. The back of this guy here has got the old traditional big old mounds of solder where I've done something. That can be worse because each time you do it, it tries to heat up all of that solder. All right, so look, technically speaking, that's it. That's actually the whole installation part of it, which is crazy. It always seems like there's got to be more to it than that. Surely there does. No, that's it. I wonder if I've got a little bit of tape to throw over those for a second. Yes, I do. I'm just going to do this so that they don't hit anything else while we're... Just put this, just show you the next part of what we're going to do. But that's it. That's the installation process. And that's only with, like I said, if you're using this on something with a reverse wound middle pickup, this is the most complicated version. And it's obviously not really very complicated. No, that might not be true in a way. I take that back. This has got the most wires to do, put it that way. So if you just have an old, like a vintage Strat, like with my amazing 74 Strat, where the pickups are all the same polarity, that's a really simple one, because that's just basically just changing two wires. So that's really, really simple. Okay, so that's that should be it. What I'm gonna do is turn the soldering iron off for a second, so we don't get any extra noise. And I'm just going to actually jump over to Facebook here for a second just to see. Thank goodness for Earth. Yes, exactly. It's important to stay earthed. Right, so I'm going to turn this back up. Plug this guy back in. Nope. Right. Now, the other part of it, let's see if you guys can see where I'm at. Maybe I will just put this down here. Okay. The only other thing you do is you just got to establish whether this little device, I'll just call it a loop because it is a little loop. It's either going to go one way or the other way. Now, I know that's the case with the three single coil. Same polarity, and I think it's going to be the same with this one. All right, so let's... Now, you got to make sure when you do this that you are touching the earth points. Because otherwise, you're going to have that much noise. Okay. So, I can already tell that that's the... it's kind of hard to hold this many spots. Right, I can already tell that that's done the job. Because now, as you listen as I go through the different positions, they're pretty much all equal. And what I'll need to do is I'll need to get these strings back on and actually put this into a into a position where I can demonstrate this better. Let me just check this for my own sake. Oh, there we go. Right. Okay, so that there is the middle pickup. That's the middle single coil is on now. That's the humbucker. Humbucker's actually got a bit more noise than the single coil. So that's what it's done. So it goes from that. Just turn this up a little more for you. I've got everything earthed here. Okay, so that's normal single coil noise. That's what I had before. Now, so all we're hearing now is just electronic noise here. But this is what we just got rid of. So that's what I want to get out of my face. Okay, so now I'm going to be able to have every position. It's going to be now where the humbucker is actually the noisiest position, which is kind of a weird thing. So yeah, that's how it works. God, my volume pot is terrible. So then the other part, as far as just closing it up and finishing it, is, let me see, oh, you guys can see they're pretty good. So the other thing that I worked for a long time on with this is making it flexible. So literally this just molds to the shape of your pickup cavity there. Flick over to this one for a second. So any of your standard kind of pickup cavities, now this is a bit thicker because it's the reverse wound model, but same kind of a deal. Basically, you just flex that so that it's going to just sit in there, right? You just kind of gently ease that in, work it around your other wires. I don't need to put this in full on yet because I'm going to go back and tidy up those solder joins and put some heat shrink on there. But essentially, that just goes in there, back over with your pick guard, and that's it. And you're going to have, it's going to be the quietest strat you've ever owned in your life. Trust me, because I've got it in a few now, and you can't go back, put it that way. And you find yourself, when you're doing gigs, you've got a choice between strats. You got your quiet one that sounds amazing, and you got your other one that sounds amazing, but you know it's a bit noisier. And because at gigs you just do not know what to expect as far as what noise is going to be there and how much noise is introduced by lighting and everything else that goes on. So the quietest strat always wins. So I'm going to finish this, tidy it up, do it a little bit nicer, and restring it, do all that sort of stuff, and I will post a video of exactly how it sounds once that's all together. So that's about it. Let me see if any questions or anything so forth. You can always send an email or go onto the Ulbrick Music Facebook page anyway, or website, and you can shoot them an email or any questions, or me. Likewise, I'll also do this. I'll have a look at this video, see if it was clear enough. Otherwise, I'll do a slightly more refined version and upload that, where you can have another look at exactly how it's done. But that's it. Look, got that done in 30 minutes. Literally, you could see that could have been done in 5 minutes. So it's a beautiful thing. All right, thanks, guys. Thanks for jumping on. And I hope to see streaming, playing guitar. Come out and see a gig. Come and see King Canyon. We're at the Hume Blues Club this week on Thursday. And then we're doing some stuff with the band.